Hi Standard 4, how are you? Okay, so for today's art lesson, we are going to create an artwork by using the perspective technique, and we are also going to use elements of lines, space, value, colors, and also shapes in your artwork today. Alright, so let's start. This is a B5 size paper. It's slightly smaller than A4. If you think your paper is too big, then you can create a frame. Okay, I'm going to use this as my ruler. I can't seem to find my ruler, so I'm going to use this. Let's say if you want to reduce the size of your sketch area or paper, right? And you create a frame like this. Okay, when you're creating a frame for your artwork, it will look so much better and it look more neat and tidy. Okay, let me do the frame first, line it. If you do not want to do the frame, and that's okay, you can just draw straight away like you normally do. Right, so let's say this is my frame. Okay, today our perspective technique is just the same with one point technique, and we are also going to make sure that things at the bottom over here will be bigger than things at the top, because you are looking upward, right? Okay, right. So once you're done with your frame, okay, find a point. We are going to find a point for your perspective later. Okay, draw the point maybe a little over here. We are going to draw a scenery of Eiffel Tower during night time. Okay, do you know Eiffel Tower? I think everyone know Eiffel Tower, right? Okay, now this is the point. Okay, don't make it too high, because we want to make sure that the road is under the Eiffel Tower itself. Okay, and then after that, maybe you can put then you can draw a line. You can use your ruler to draw the line, but if you do not want to use the ruler and you are confident with drawing without ruler, then that's absolutely okay. Right, so let's imagine this is the road heading to the Eiffel Tower. Okay, it doesn't have to be straight, too straight, right? And then over here there would be some, maybe you can put some flowers or bushes, okay, leading towards the Eiffel Tower. But you need to make sure when it's going toward the end of the road, it should get smaller and smaller. Big become smaller and smaller, all right? Okay, and then after that, you can add more details and over here later on. Now let's try with the Eiffel Tower itself. Okay, we are going to draw the Eiffel Tower where the bottom is bigger than the top. Okay, so let's say this is the leg. Just draw a circle. Okay, something like this. Right? And after that, we are going to draw the body going upward like this. Okay, so you can start from here and then make it as symmetrical as possible later. It's the top of the tower, and same goes to this one. Okay, as symmetrical as possible until the top. There you go. Okay, and you might not be able to see the top, that's okay. You can draw it until over here. Okay, and if you notice at the Eiffel Tower, you do have a few floors, right? Then you can create some floors by drawing the straight line. Okay, then after that, they do have one space over here, empty space. Okay. And after that, one more floor. If you want to continue with the floor, that should be okay as well. Another floor if you want to. And if you want to add more details on this by using textures, elements, you can do that as well. Later on, we will try to put as many shadow as we can on the building itself to make it look more 3D. Alright? Okay, now, let's see what we can do after this. Right now, maybe we can put this as a night time, and then we want to make the tower to look bright in the dark. We are going to color this in yellow, and the background should be in dark blue or black, right? And then maybe you can put moon over here and also some stars. Okay, and for this one, this part over here, you can put as much detail as you want, but need to make sure that things at the front should be bigger, right? That's how perspective technique works. So for example, if you want to put light over here, I'm going to draw some light, street light, okay, then this is the lamp, okay, and as it go toward the tower, it should be, it gets smaller and smaller. There you go, right? Okay, now we are going to start with the coloring. Okay, for this part over here, you can draw, you can color it in either gray or brown color, but I think I'm going to use green today. Green for this, the rod, and also for the bushes of flowers next to the rod. And for the lamp later, I'm going to use yellow and black for the lamp post. Okay, right, so let's start with the coloring. Okay, so if you see over here, I have created some shadow by using the element of value. I created some shadow over here under the bushes, okay, to create more depth and 3D effect, okay. And after that, you can also use the same black or dark color to create a fluffy effect on the bushes, where you can just draw some like curve lines on the bush to make it look like the bush is bushy, right? And if the line is too harsh, then you can just do the dabbing technique. Okay, you rub it with your finger. So now I'm going to start coloring the tower itself, and after that I will add some shadow on the tower as well as some dark color to create more 3D effect on it later, okay? Okay, standard file. So this is the end of today's art lesson. You can do some color blending over here. I use gray color, light blue, and also I blend it together with the darker blue by using white color just now. Okay, And for this part over here, try to blend the yellow color with the green color to make it look like the light from the tower itself is shining on, it's reflected on the grass over here as well. Okay? Do your best.